My name is Kadara Enyeasi. I'm an artist. I started taking pictures at the age of 13 and eventually I started taking self-portraits. I explore ideas of sexuality, of politics, body politics, especially black body politics. At the time I started taking self-portraits, I was in university studying architecture. At that time, I didn't really know much about contemporary African photographers. I didn't know nothing. I was just making images for the fun of making images. One very funny day, Lucky messaged me. He was asking me these questions. Have I seen this person's work? Have I seen that person's work? He was mentioning Sassen or J.K. Ray, CDB. So he gave me a list and I went back home and I was looking at their work. And I think something broke in my head. You have people that are shooting work that is strong, that has ideas behind it that make you think. They just make you wonder why you're doing what you're doing and what you're trying to say with what you're doing. And you have people that are just doing work to cash out. I think what's really exciting about living in this time is the fact that you're exposed so much. I think the industry has been tensioned in a way. People are no longer creating shitty work. So everyone is on their A game, trying to look for the next interesting idea, trying to look for the next interesting location, trying to look for the next interesting face to shoot. I see social media as a big peer parlor. I mean, everyone is there ranting about something, be it their work, be it another person's work, be it the news. Social media has come thus far in making circulation of your work, the dispersion of your work, easier and faster. Because then you have this amount of people, important people that are looking at your work. So, say 75% of my commissions come from social media. So I don't think I'm facing any challenge in keeping true to myself, in maintaining the authenticity of my work, being that I know what I want to shoot, I know how I want to shoot what I want to shoot. So normally what I do is I let ideas sit in my head over time. So you're telling me that you want to shoot in 2 weeks, in a month's time. I don't think about the idea. I don't think about what I want to do. I get to the scene and I see what is available and I try to make it work. That's my style of shooting. I don't know if it works for any other person else. That has allowed me to stay true to who I am. Technology in a way has advanced the way people shoot. With shooting digital, like I said, I like achieving everything in camera, so I don't really have to fuss in post-production. I don't like removing things, I don't like removing items. I mean, if you want flawless skin, bring a model with flawless skin. If you want acne and bumps, you get acne and bumps. I think, in one sentence, African fashion photography is heading towards that whole, I think it's a trend, Afrofuturism. I think I'm a bit pessimistic about what photography in the future is going to be. There is one thing with Africans, and this applies to Nigerians as well. We have this, I think it's a disease now, because we copy a lot. We like to imitate what we see. And we forget that we had a past and there was a way we were coming. So I think the direction we're going to is either we run out of ideas and keep copying. I don't know, do we have ideas to start with? But then we run out of things to reference. Someone said it recently that even our designers, they don't have an idea as to what the African aesthetic is. And I think it's true.